Hi, my name is Austin Niemeyer and I'm the Business Analyst for Infor Homepages, and in this video we are going to be going over the basics for a Homepages user. Before we get started on the end user basics for Homepages, let's do a brief introduction on Homepages itself. Infor Homepages is a single entry point to your entire application suite. The Homepages application is comprised of role-based pages. These pages utilize a grouping of widgets, which are a small, single-purpose application to help an end user complete their day-to-day work more efficiently. When an end user first visits Homepages, they will have the option to create a new page or access the page catalog. I'm going to go ahead and demonstrate how to create a new page. When you begin creating a new page, you'll have the option to add a name, description, and a page color. For this example, I'll make a manager page and I'll use the color amber. Once the page has been created, you'll have the option to add one of two widgets, a standard widget or a banner widget. We'll begin with a normal widget. Selecting Add Widget brings the end user to the widget catalog. Here they'll have access to every widget for which they have permissions to view. I'm going to go ahead and add some widgets that a manager may find helpful for their day-to-day work. Now that we have added some widgets, we can select Save and see what the page looks like. As you can see, you'll have some widgets that are configured and then some that need to be configured. I'll go ahead and configure the menu widget to show you an example of a widget that needs to be configured. I will go ahead and add links for Google and Infor. Also note as I'm doing this that not all widgets have the same type of configuration. Different widgets need different configuration and they'll show different data based on what you configure the widget to show. Now we will do the same thing except for instead of a normal widget, we're going to be using banner widgets. By selecting Edit in the top right hand corner and then selecting Add Banner Widget. The banner area is going to be used for your most pertinent information, so when you're going through as an end user, you need to make sure to put the data which you want to view most at the top of your page. For this example, we're going to go ahead and add the IDM Documents widget and also the IoT Devices widget. Now that we have added both widgets, as you can see, the IDM Documents widget needs to be configured. I'll go ahead and configure this now. Once completed, all the end user has to do is hit Save, and then they can view their entire page. Lastly, a user can add any standard or published page by simply selecting the page catalog from the Homepages menu. Once selected, they can add any page to their list of pages. As we talked about in the last section, a user can access the page or widget catalog in order to add pages or widgets. We will begin with the widget catalog. As discussed before, the widget catalog can be accessed by editing the page and then selecting the add option in either the standard area or the banner area. The widget catalog is going to list all the widgets for which an end user has permissions to see. So if the user has access to the IDM application, they will also have access to the widgets related to IDM. The widget catalog also shows a combination of different types of widgets. They have both standard and published widgets. The standard widget comes standard with Infor OS, and a published widget is a standard widget that has been configured and published to the catalog by another user or administrator. Since the widget catalog can contain a lot of content, the Homepages team has added features to make finding widgets in the catalog as simple as possible. To begin, a user can simply search for the widget in the catalog by selecting the search icon in the top right-hand corner of the page and searching for the name of the widget. If the user does not know the exact name of the widget, they can always find the widget by using the filtering options on the left-hand side of the widget catalog. They can filter by category, by application, by the owner of the widget, by the tag, or by the type, whether it's standard or published. After a user has filtered to find a widget, They can always save the filter by selecting the Save filter in the top right-hand corner of the widget catalog. Also, if you do not know whether you are adding the correct widget or not, you can always view more details of the widget by selecting the widget and viewing the description or any images if they have any. Now on to the page catalog. As we discussed before, the page catalog can be accessed by selecting the Homepages menu and selecting the Page Catalog option. The page catalog is going to show all of the standard and published pages for which a user has access to. The page catalog also offers all the exact same features as the widget catalog that I just previously went over. A user can search, filter, and view more details of any pages within the catalog. As discussed in the previous section, published widgets are standard widgets that are configured and published to the widget catalog by a user or administrator. In order to publish a widget, you must first select the widget menu, go under Advanced, select Publish, and then you must begin by choosing the name and description you want for the widget. Note that the name you enter here will be the name seen in the widget catalog unless the Use Widget Catalog title as the widget title is selected below. The description will also be the description seen in the catalog once you publish it. Next, you have the options to add any tags or a standard size to the published widget. As discussed in the last section, the tags can be used to search the widget in the widget catalog. The standard size will be the size of the widget when an end user adds the published widget to their page. The settings tab will vary from widget to widget, but it will allow you to enable certain settings by default when a user adds the widget to their own page. Next is the Translations tab. Here you will be able to add, import, or export any translations you want for the widget. For example, if I wanted the widget title to translate to La Carta, when Spanish is the language for a user, I can enter it here. I could then export that translation and any translations that come standard with the widget by selecting the export option here. If I wanted to and I had any translation files on hand, I could also import those translations by selecting the import option here. Lastly is the permissions tab. Here's where I can restrict access to this published widget. For example, if I wanted the only user to be able to configure the widget to be Alicia On, and everybody else to only be able to view and add it to their page, I could simply add the user Alicia On, give her the access to configure the widget, and give everyone else the access to only view only. Once I apply these changes, I will then need to select Publish in the top right hand corner of the page to publish the widget to the widget catalog. And after this, at any point if I wanted to make any changes to the published widget, I could select the widget menu on that widget, go under Advanced, and then Edit Publish Configuration. You can then make any changes you want to the widget and then republish it to the widget catalog. In order to publish a page, the user must select the Homepages menu, go under Advanced, and select Publish. You'll have all the same options that are viewed when publishing a widget, with the additional actions to show a page link and show announcements under the header. The Show Page Link option will allow a user to add a link in the header of the homepage for others to use. When a user selects the link, it'll open up in a new tab. The Show Announcements below Page Header option will allow for announcements to show under the page header if any announcements pertain to the end user. I will go over more about the announcements in another video. Once a user is finished with their published page, they can select Apply and then publish it to the page catalog. That is all for the Working with Homepages user basics. Thank you for watching the video, and if you have any outstanding questions, please feel free to email me at austin.niemeyer@infor.com or visit docs.infor.com and view the Homepages user guide.